You're listening to iCannabisRadio.com.
And my producer tells me it's Thursday night and we're back on Overgrowth Radio.
Yes, it is.
Yeah, welcome. What up, Holly G?
iCannabis.
Wow, that was a little loud coming in. Maybe I shouldn't yell the next time, huh?
You're going to yell at our guests?
I always yell at our guests. That's why they love us. So it's Thursday. It's mile. We are in the mile high, and I think I'm not quite a mile high tonight. I did a dab this afternoon, and then I kind of went home and relaxed for a bit.
We're always a mile high here in Denver.
Yeah, speak for yourself. I live soberly. Speaking of which, we've got stories. We've got a lot of news to try to get to in the next 15 minutes before we welcome Dixie Elixirs. We have Tamar and Miss Christy Lunsford over there. She's raising the roof right now. She's all excited. It's like our little holiday segment with you guys because I think, you know, we were going to take next week off and just goof off because we've never played a rerun. But we're talking about doing a holiday show, but you guys will be off working hard. So this is it. So we'll get to you guys in a few. Enjoy. But first, there's a lot going on. As everyone knows, on Monday, Mr. Governor Hickenlooper signed Amendment 64 into law.
Yay!
We got confused. I think a lot of people did. We thought that he had the 30 days from the election. We didn't realize he had an extension of 30 days.
The 30 days.
And then he came in pretty quickly, in my mind, and signed it, you know, did his executive order. So
it wasn't too painful for us.
No, I thought it was great, you know. The article I read today was pretty interesting. It brings up some good points, you know, that the federal government can seek to block the implementation of regulations, but the thing that it can't do is make Washington or Colorado recriminalize cannabis.
Right.
And that alone is huge. Like, they can't come in and say, okay, we're the feds, now you have to make it illegal again.
The voters have spoken.
Very loudly, 55%. You know.
Yeah, that's
like
awesome.
Keep
I don't.
Reminding that.
Yeah, I think that what most people are afraid of is them going into the stores and stuff, if that tries to, you know, if people try to open their legal stores.
Well, let's talk about that for a second. You just segued in. I didn't get to fill Miss Holly G in. She was stuck up in the snowy mountains this week, so we didn't get to have our coffee meeting. A friend of mine has a little thing called iComply. We sit on another board together, but iComply put this out, I think, this week. It's brand new. And it's just a little brief thing for people to hang on, like, the front door of their dispensary. You know, number one, that's the thing. We want to talk about that, I wanted to talk about that this evening for a couple minutes. You can't drive to Colorado and buy cannabis right now. It is illegal. You will not be able to do so, at least until 2014. And, you know, personal guess is it's going to be a little bit longer than that.
They said they're just going to start maybe thinking about it at the end of 2013 and get letting applications go out or whatever process they're going to put
that,
in place.
Right, and that we're going to talk about the task force in a minute. But that being said, you know, there are a lot of gray areas. There's a lot of open areas right now. There's a lot of avenues people may explore, and there may there may be private clubs. There may be different things before then. But what you can do right now is you can drive to Colorado, and a friend of yours who's over 21 can hand you up to an ounce of cannabis if you're over 21.
For free.
For free. And that is perfectly legal. And I, you know, Ken Gorman, for anyone who knows that name, has got to really just love this right now.
He gave away a lot of free cannabis.
I never got to meet him. He died a very mysterious death here in Denver. If anyone who's not familiar, you should Google and
quite interesting.
That's another story in and amongst itself that we can't get into, but definitely Google that name, and I'm sure he's smiling from up above right now. And that's the way it should be. You should be able to give anyone cannabis.
Free cannabis for everybody.
Absolutely.
Yay!
So I want to run down this list and give kudos to Mark and iComply for coming out with this because, you know, we do. I think most of us in the industry try to promote responsible use. On a quick side note, I saw a YouTube video that was out on like the LA Times or something website of four people on the Capitol stairs smoking a joint.
Oh, I saw that.
Still illegal. Not a good representation at all. So, you know, that being said, I guess my point is when we're out there, you know, yes, we are free to use cannabis now, but let's do so with a little bit of common sense. The first thing is obviously it's 21 and over. Respect that. Don't go give it to your 16-year-old nephew because he's cool and he hangs out with you, you know.
Unless they're ill and have their cannabis card, exactly. Their medical cannabis card.
Well, that's the second part of that is if you are a patient, you can remain a patient if you're under 21. That's not going to change. It also talks about, and I just laugh a little, don't smuggle it outside of Colorado. Don't ship it through the mail, UPS, or FedEx. You know, there is no interstate commerce, as our guests can vouch for. You know, we're working on that. I think someday soon we'll have that in place. There's, to my knowledge, and there may be more now, but there were 5 states. If you're a red card holder in Colorado, there were 5 states you could fly to with your meds. That's great, but it does me no good when I go medless to go see my daughter. You know,
right?
So.
It's no fun.
Number 2 on this list is pretty obvious. Don't use and drive. And, you know, I might upset people and friends by saying this, but some people have to use to do anything in life. It becomes a maintenance medication, but use your best judgment. I don't feel impaired when I do what I do throughout the day. It's part of my day. It's like me taking a Tylenol. Unfortunately, I sometimes wish I still got that buzz. It used to be kind of fun when I was a teenager. But, you know, I use it as medicine and know the effects of it on your body. Just be smart about it, you know?
And I think, did you see the video of the guy that lives here in Denver that exposed Fox News? He was one of the members that they did in the drunk or in the intoxicated driving test because they wanted to see how stoned drivers tested. Mm-hmm. And you can find it on YouTube. It's a video about exposing Fox News and their intoxicated driving tests for cannabis.
They were saying it was worse than what it was, I'm sure.
Right. He actually brought his own camera and filmed all the footage aside of their camera. And so he exposed how they edited it with his camera.
Fox News is good at that. I worked with them. I mean, and to digress, kudos to them in a lot of aspects. The local Fox down in Colorado Springs, they were awesome. They were actually my favorite, ironically, station that I worked with during Occupy. they were the best at not chopping my words. But anyway, historically and generally speaking, yes, Fox News is
scary.
Notorious for that. You know, again, just don't get all high and drive. There's a point where you need to be on couch lock, and please do so. Set and setting, it's kind of the same thing, you know. Realize where you're at, your time, your place, your mood. If it's a good time to medicate, well, I guess it's not medicating. If it's a good time to get high, if your psyche is in the right place, do so. If you're at home relaxing at night and you need an indica, do so. Obviously, during the day, when I say I function, I don't smoke 100% indica and go throughout the day.
Choose what's right for your body and, you know, the dosage that's right for you. Don't
absolutely
overdo it if you're going to travel.
The next one's a little debatable to me. Not really, because our culture, people get addicted to Big Macs. Cannabis is not physically addictive. It says resist abuse. And it's not addiction. It's 2 different things. You know, you can abuse coffee. I do daily. and Big Macs and everything else that's wrong with society. Again, just, you know, it comes back to common sense. You know, don't sit around in your grandma's basement for the rest of your life smoking cannabis. Be a user. Oh, God, I hate words like that.
Productive stoner.
Exactly. Go out and do something. Be a part of society. And respect the rights of others. Unlike California, and I don't agree with this, I'm just against everything tonight. But, you know, you can't smoke outdoors. I feel you should be able to. I mean, hell, up in Canada, you can smoke your vape on plane. Well, in airports and on buses and public transit. You used to be able to smoke your vapes on planes up there, but they ruled that was unsafe. So,
can't say I haven't done it.
You really? I can't say that I haven't smoked a vape pen in the elevator of a certain courthouse that I won't name.
you just blow the vape. You know, it's not really smoke. The you know, the just the vaporized smoke into your jacket.
I didn't hear that, Holly. What are you condoning?
No one will know.
Jimmy Carter, real quick. It was pretty cool that he came out. I mean, it's no big secret. He's kind of been a supporter of legalization, or at least decriminalization, since his presidency. There were bills that came up during his presidency that for decriminalization that he always supported and always got shot down by the neocons. That was back when Cheney and all his buddies, his little neocon group, were running rampant in D.C. and being ridiculous.
Crazy.
And another thing that's really not too surprising is there's some new polls out after 64. I don't know if you guys have seen these, but they're interesting. There's a Gallup poll that was released Monday that says 34% of people want the feds to step in and kick your door down and your door down and my door down and you know, take us and put us in a cage. And 64% of Americans say that's ridiculous. you know, there's another, well, there's a few more polls listed here. There's one that supports the legalization by 51%, another one's 59%. I think the point here is America as a whole has seen and sees what's going on, and they see, guess what, it's not a big boogeyman. Not at all. And how about some irony? Do you like irony?
Sure.
HSBC. Anyone who's been around money, banks, knows that name. It's, no. Say I'm so mean sometimes. 5 minutes. Sheesh. I can't do the rest of this news in 5 minutes, Sam. What am I supposed to do with that? But I'll work with it. Okay, anyway. London, it's a big London bank, a big, you know, central bank for those people who are into those whole, you know, conspiracy Federal Reserve type things, and you know, I don't know anything about that. But anyway, they were they just had to forfeit in a ruling, have to forfeit $1.256 billion because they were caught with their hand in the cookie jar. They're the latest. They were laundering money for drug cartels. You know, some people would say, well, that's not a big deal. It's not a big story, except for the fact that they're like the fifth bank since, 2006 that this has happened to. And they're not small banks. I mean, it's Wachovia, the SIG Corporation, which I believe is a big German bank. American Express International Bank was caught. You know, the list goes on. And it's just blatant. What happens here is the banks can get away with it. Their penalty is they have to pay money. Well, guess what? Banks have that money to pay, so that's not really a penalty. If you or I went and laundered money for drug cartels, or if we ran bundles across the border, do you think we would just get off with a few fines and a slap on the wrist?
Maybe.
That's a very big maybe with not a lot of confidence behind it. So we will. I think we can squeeze through the rest of this news. Maybe. Maybe not. I had to use the maybe word. So Palm Springs, California, medical marijuana news. They have ordered unpermitted dispensaries to shut down. I can
By
stop.
By schools?
Well, it's just anything that's unpermitted. And I can stop right there. It looks like it's very vague in this article, and it looks like it's a city permit. That's the problem with Cali. And we've talked in a few of the different shows last 2 weeks ago with Angela, or last week. And, you know, they expressed this too, is the regulation has not been there. What happens is they let these businesses just pop up and, oh, well, you know, it's okay. You can have a permit if you want. But then they come back and they're like, oh, wow. They have, like, cannabis flags hanging over our roads and, like, you know, half-naked sign twirlers in the middle of traffic. Maybe we should rethink this. It's just, you know, I think it's a big reason why the feds go in and pick on them. You know, I think there's a lot of problems that stem from the lack of regulation out there. I think that story just reflects what goes on a daily basis. You know, I hope that things in Cali move in the right direction. I hope that they kind of step back. You know, I'd like to see them be the next to legalize and on the next election cycle.
Yeah, they should be.
Yeah, they really should.
No reason not to.
They birthed it. They did, you know, one of our, well, repeated guests, Dennis Perrone, was there for the inception of medical. And, you know, they should be at the top, and unfortunately, they weren't the first. Right. So. Mendocino County, speaking of examples, had this great program up there where the sheriff got to know all the growers, because anyone who knows Mendocino knows that it's full of outside grows. So what they did is they created a tag program, and they went around and they tagged all these grows that said, okay, this grow's okay, it's been inspected, yada, yada, yada. And the feds now, I don't know why, but my theory is they probably took offense to them working with them. And they've come in now, and it's been ongoing for a bit. They've subpoenaed the county's records. Well, it looks like the Mendocino County is actually fighting back. They're actually going to fight the feds on this one. So I just want to say kudos to them for that. Oh, God, we're out of time. Sam's going to shoot me. Real quick, I just want to mention the task force the governor assembled this week. You know, for me, it's a double-edged sword. I think it's great that he took the initiative to move forward so quickly with a task force. That being said, I was a little hurt because I was actually nominated by one of the boards I sit on to be a part of that task force and would have loved to have been. And not just on my side of it, but from all patients and activists and the medical and industry side, really, I don't see a lot of representation on that task force for us. What I see is a lot of political people, a lot of politicians, and I don't think that they're going to move this in the direction that it should be moving. And I think that's sad. And I really, you know, I hope if anyone does monitor our show and watch us from government agencies, if you will, that you guys take that to heart and that you somehow find a way to include the industry and patients and patients groups. So on that note, we're going to go pay some bills, and we will be back in just a few minutes with these two lovely patient ladies who have been hiding over here in the corner. So stick with us on Overgrow the Radio on iCannabisRadio.com. Peace.
Dixie Elixirs and Edibles, the nation's premier infused product manufacturer, brings you the newest in hemp CBD wellness products, Dixie X. Derived from CBD from medicinal hemp, this non-psychoactive cannabinoid provides the medicinal effects of cannabis, but without the high. Join the Dixie X revolution today at www.dixiex.com. Or like us on Facebook, Dixie X or Dixie Elixirs.
Hi, I'm Josh Stanley.
And I'm Jesse Stanley.
Two of the brothers here from National Geographic's American Weed. And we'd like to invite you to come into our dispensaries in Dispensary in Colorado Springs. Come in for the most pure organic strain selection in Colorado. It's all hand grown by the Stanley brothers, especially for our patients. So come in and visit us at our two locations, East Platte and West Colorado. And remember,
always be kind to each other.
The law offices of Edson, Meaton, and Matz provide criminal defense, medical marijuana defense, and advice about setting up and running medical marijuana centers, optional premises, cultivation operations, and infused product manufacturing businesses throughout Colorado. With offices in Denver and Aspen, we can offer assistance throughout the entire state of Colorado. Give us a call at 303-831-8188. That's 303-831-8188. Or visit us online at warrenedson.com.
The Hemp Con is Colorado's premier guide to hemp culture. Our mission is to elevate the image of the medical cannabis and hemp industries to create widespread acceptance for all of the uses of the cannabis plant. You can find the Hemp Connoisseur in over 200 7-Elevens, your local dispensary, MMJ doctor offices, and tattered covered bookstores. Also, visit us online at thcmag.com or download our brand new app for your smartphone.
Hi, Josh Stanley here from National Geographic's American Weed. I'm here with my brothers, and we've just recently put together a foundation in Colorado to allow for cancer patients and other patients of debilitating conditions to be able to get a hold of cannabis-based oil that's just about free of charge. I've just about had it with seeing sick patients suffer needlessly just because they can't afford the proper medication. That's what the Realm of Caring is going to change. Visit therealmofcaring.com. The website will be complete and up on 4/20 of 2012. But until then, please contact any of us Stanley brothers directly through email. You can get us at GratefulJosh@hotmail.com. Now come on, Colorado. We need to take care of each other. Join the realm. That's realmofcaring.com. Thank you so much.
We're back here on Overgrow the Radio, iCannabisRadio.com. You can also go to our website at iCannabisRadio.com and join our chat. You can keep the silly name it gives you, or you can change it to your own customized name and come in here and tell us what you think.
Yeah.
Let us know if you have any questions as well, or updates from your side of the country or your side of the world. We'd love to hear it.
I see all you people who like log in and then log out of chat. You're kind of lame. You should really talk to us, and then maybe I'd talk more. Sheesh.
All those people hiding out there listening.
So we're honored to welcome back. Excuse me, I lost my voice for a second. Christy Lunsford and Tamar Wise from Dixie Elixirs. Hello, how are you ladies?
Great, thank you so much.
Dixie is a valued part of our show. We've been really lucky to be a part of some really big announcements in your guys' growth and livelihood, if you will. It's been fun. And then, you know, Tamar. I am going to keep pronouncing that right until it actually comes out right every time. Tamar, actually, we've had a lot of feedback about wanting you back on the show. Now, I don't know how much science we're going to be able to get into, but our listeners and viewers welcome you back anytime, I think. We love to be educated. So, Christy just talks way too much. That's what they say. No, I'm kidding.
It's true. I have a lot to say.
No, you guys actually, your segments seem to get the widest feedback, I notice, of all the people we talk to. And that's saying something, because we've talked to, you know, presidential candidates and different people. So, mm-hmm. Dixie must be doing big things. Kudos. So, you guys... you know, I just talk and talk, but you guys have, like I said, you've announced some things on here, and tonight it's kind of no exception. You're got this new product line that I myself have seen, you know, people benefit from, and it's, you know, why kind of our partnership formed and in the vested interest that I took. And, you know, it sounds like you're kind of revamping something, so I'm going to let you kind of jump in and...
So... We are having a bit of a shift. We are rebranding Dixie X as Dixie Botanicals Hemp Oil Wellness Supplements. The X was really a placeholder for us, and now that we better understand how our customers are using the products and the reasons why they're buying them, we've chosen to rename the brand Dixie Botanicals. And the goal is to have something that better reflects the natural quality of the products and the integrity behind that quality that we're bringing to the brand. We will be introducing the new brand during the Christmas holiday and rolling out the website and all the marketing materials, new labels as well. You can still purchase the product line from DixieX.com right now, going well up until the new year. If I use the salve, which we're renaming Salvation Balm, Dixie Botanicals Hemp Oil Salvation Balm, that was really from customer feedback on how it worked for them. Salvation Balm was a suggestion, and we've worked so hard on the integrity of the products. We source our beeswax, our cocoa butter, our essential oil blend from a nationally known herbal arts company, the raw materials. And then we combine it with our proprietary hemp oil here in Colorado to manufacture the brand that will be called Dixie Botanicals. So that's just an example of the why, the how, and the what behind the rebranding.
I like the name change a lot. It sounds a lot easier on the ears, and it does feel better to hear that Dixie Botanicals, Dixie X. I mean, it's a cool name, but it sounds a lot harsher.
Exactly.
So I really like it.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Well, it was awesome. Like Mr. X, and now that you've, you know, it's like the old dating game. I'm not really that old, but I remember reruns, and you know, didn't they name them all Mr. X? And then at the end of the game, you got to see the real face of the person. So I did notice I was on your guys' website. I check up on you, I visit and stuff. And you guys took the mention of CBDs out of that. Are there changes to the products as far as
so
that?
That's a really great question. The products themselves are exactly the same as before. Essentially what we're doing, the products still contain CBD, cannabidiol, which we are now referring to as hemp oil. We're revising the website to come further in compliance with the FDA and FTC guidelines. CBD has been called hemp oil for a very long time, ever since Rick Simpson's hemp oil became well known. However, hemp oil in our circumstance falls under the FDA guidelines for a dietary supplement. So we need to be extremely diligent in our labeling and our marketing claims. So our approach is completely within compliance.
Well, and I'll branch off that and say that, you know, on a side note, not that I do it personally or ever would, but I will never bash Rick Simpson because, you know, helping sick people is what it is, no matter where they're at. It's not fair. They don't have the right to oil. Everyone should. But that being said, he's also had a lot of negative connotation because it is breaking the law. And you know, the people in his network, if you will, are shipping oil when it shouldn't be done. So I think from a business standpoint, it's very important to distinguish yourselves. You know I use a similar oil to his and for my pain. And I know that the folks that I get my oil from, you know, are very diligent as well. For that reason.
So is when you say hemp oil, I've heard people call hemp oil Phoenix Tears. Is that the same thing?
Actually, that's a great question, Tamar.
So Phoenix Tears, actually, it is called hemp oil, or it's referred to as hemp oil, but it is not actually made from hemp. Rick Simpson is he's adamant about hemp and cannabis being the same thing. They are of the same species, but the major difference is the THC and CBD content. So whereas Phoenix Tears does use cannabis and actually cannabis flower, I do believe it's indica, it still has a much higher THC content than our Dixie Botanicals hemp oil, which is actually made from industrial hemp, and the THC content of the plant is much, much lower.
So you can't really get a high off of it?
Right, and when it's refined and we do our purification process, there's only trace elements left.
Okay. Cool.
Cool. Well, since awesome. We have Tamar talking, there are other benefits, and we've probably hit on this, you know, many times, but we always want to the line of products. Do you want to go into those? Because there's more than just CBDs that you get from these products. So.
Yes, absolutely. Actually, CBD is just one of 85 phytocannabinoids. THC, CBN, CBG, THCV, the list goes on. As far as there's also non-cannabinoid phenols. There's bioflavonoids, terpenoids. Let's see, there's vitamin K. Hemp is actually a complete source of protein. Let's see what else. It also has fatty acids, omega 3, 6, and 9. I do believe it's one of the rare plants that contain all three of them. It has calcium. Let's see. I think I covered most of the important. So as you can see, the list goes on. It is literally one of the healthiest things that you can eat. And there are medicinal benefits from flavonoids, terpenoids, and they all work together as well with entourage effects. So
I recently debated, and I'm going to get sidetracked because I like to do that to you guys and have some fun. Recently debated someone in my life, and I've heard this for years, and it makes sense to me because, you know, I've somewhat become educated by hanging out with smart people anyway. I've heard that a hemp seed is the only food source, if you will, that you can survive solely on that.
Yes.
How does that work? How do you live off of a seed?
Because hemp seed, actually, as I was listing these things, I was including the entire plant, but hemp seed is definitely, I'd say, one of the most important parts of the plant. It contains all the, as I was listing, the fatty acids, protein. So what you're getting is, in that little seed, you're getting a ratio of all the nutrients that your body needs to survive. So if you were to only eat one food, hemp would be the absolute best choice.
And there's a mystic, Siddhartha Gautama, who we commonly refer to as Buddha. It's said that he sustained himself on a hemp seed a day for 3 years during his during his mystic journey of enlightenment. So it really has been a companion plant to humankind through the ages.
My producer claims to be a Buddhist. Sam, did you know that?
Siddhartha.
Yes,
Siddhartha.
Absolutely. If you've not read that book, you should. It will teach you a valuable life lesson. Siddhartha, on a side note, is a great book.
It absolutely is.
And like, I don't know. Well, we'll probably just do it now. I think we have to pay you guys again and take a commercial break. When we come back, we've got, oh gosh, all kinds of more. Fun more stuff to talk about. I jumbled those words and twisted them horribly. So we'll be right back on Overgrow the Radio. Peace.
The Hemp Connoisseur is Colorado's premier guide to hemp culture. Our mission is to elevate the image of the medical cannabis and hemp industries to create widespread acceptance for all of the uses of the cannabis plant. You can find The Hemp Connoisseur in over 200 7-Elevens, your local dispensary, MMJ doctor offices, and tattered covered bookstores. Also, visit us online at thcmag.com or download our brand new app for your smartphone.
Dixie Elixirs and Edibles, the patient's choice for alternative medical marijuana treatment. Dixie Elixirs infuse sparkle beverages, Dixie Edibles, Dewdrops, Tonics, and Dixie Scripts Extraordinarily Concentrated Cannabis Extract Capsules, along with Dixie Botanicals, all-natural topical therapy. All of these medicinal remedies are available at your local medical marijuana center. Like us on Facebook, Dixie Elixirs, or join us at www.dixieelixirs.com.
Hi, Josh Stanley here from National Geographic's American Weed. I'm here with my brothers, and we've just recently put together a foundation in Colorado to allow for cancer patients and other patients of debilitating conditions to be able to get a hold of cannabis-based oil that's just about free of charge. I've just about had it with seeing sick patients suffer needlessly just because they can't afford the proper medication. That's what the Realm of Caring is going to change. Visit therealmofcaring.com. The website will be complete and up on 420 of 2012. But until then, please contact any of us Stanley brothers directly through email. You can get us at gratefuljosh@hotmail.com. Now come on, Colorado. We need to take care of each other. Join the realm. That's realmofcaring.com. Thank you so much.
The Hemp Connoisseur is Colorado's premier guide to hemp culture. Our mission is to elevate the image of the medical cannabis and hemp industries to create widespread acceptance of the cannabis sativa plant. You can find the latest issue of The Hemp Connoisseur at more than 200 7-Elevens, your favorite dispensary, MMJ doctor offices, and tattered covered bookstores. Do you consider yourself a cannabis connoisseur? Then come be a part of the Hemp Connoisseur's first cannabis championship. Visit us at thcmag.com for info on how to sample the best medicine Colorado has to offer.
That Mad Hatter Smoke Shop has everything from space glass to butane and butane accessories, I tell you what. Located at 6901 West Colfax in Lakewood, and now at 2615 Walnut Street in Denver. Ah! God damn it, Reclaim, put your pants back on.
And we're back here on Overgrow the Radio, iCannabisRadio.com. I'm Holly G, and we're here with Stickman.
Holly G.
Yes. How's everybody doing out there?
Your name just has a ring to it.
Holly G.
Holly G.
Ganja.
You are kind of OG. You've been doing radio since I was like a kid. Well, we're the same. You're much younger than me, I'm sure, actually. But anyway.
For a lifetime.
Yeah, right? Yeah, that happens that way. You'll never catch me. I don't know. When I die, does it keep adding up? Like, because women do live longer than men, so.
Who knows?
You know, if I die in my 70s and you keep going, does that mean you're eventually older?
You know, I may be 28 on my license, but who knows how old we really are.
Somebody mentioned Buddha. Now we're all getting all deep and philosophical.
Very spiritual.
Philosophical
now.
And whatnot. So anyway, we are joined with our friends from Dixie, Christy and Tamar. And yay, I got her name right like four times in a row. I mentioned before, I keep saying that, but I went to school with I'm sure lady by now, speaking of getting older, who is Tamar. So for me, it's just naturally how I say it. I'm sorry.
No worries.
No lack of love. But you guys are great. We always welcome you. We always learn from you. And I wanted to kind of delve back in, digress a little bit, and talk more about the oil and the real differences there. I know in the break you were mentioning words in passing that were confusing me, so I'm just going to let you talk about them.
I did touch upon the major difference, which is cannabis versus hemp. Another major difference is the process and the solvent that is used. We do use an ethanol solvent right now. We are upgrading very soon to a much better solvent. But for right now, we are using ethanol, and we also have a vacuum purging process. And our refinement process takes over a couple days versus, as far as I know, Phoenix Tears is cooked down in rice cookers, mm-hmm. and the solvent of choice is naphtha, which is actually gasoline. It is mm-hmm. a byproduct of the refinement from petroleum into gasoline. So it is used for paint thinner. It's in Bic lighters. Actually, it was the first napalm was made with naphtha. So it is a much more volatile, much more flammable liquid. It's also heavier. So the type of evaporation that's used usually isn't enough to pull all of those heavy molecules out. So you do have trace solvent left in the oil.
So it's not exactly food safe.
Yes.
Well, not only that, I mean, it is scary. And I think people, you know, watch the videos, if you will, mm-hmm. on YouTube of the oil being made.
Yeah.
And, you know, you're desperate when you're sick. And, mm-hmm. and you really, it's a process that you have to know what you're doing, especially when you're using things like gasoline.
Do not do it indoors.
Well, yeah, mm-hmm. I've seen photos of apartments where the wall's missing because of it, literally from it exploding.
And the thing about what Dixie Botanicals hemp oil products are offering is they're offering you hemp oil made from hemp that is legal in all 50 states, that can be shipped via the U.S. Postal Service, and that's made with scientific integrity, that's purged appropriately. Before coming down to the studio, Tamar and I just had dinner, and we were talking about the difference between someone who has a compromised immune system and what that means to be using, you know, to be in that kind of situation where you have to make that choice. And that's why the Dixie Botanical hemp oil product range is so important. We have a capsule, which is a concentrated hemp oil supplement now. And then the dewdrops, we have the two different formulas, which are a dewdrops hemp oil supplement. These are dietary supplements, but what we've come to better understand is how people are purchasing them and what kind of health and wellness goals they have, and that they're coming to understand that they have a choice now. They don't have to have this potentially carcinogenic ingredient, and they don't have to skirt the law, that there is a compliant dietary product that they can use to perhaps achieve those wellness goals.
And they can use it in non-legal states.
Yes, yes.
Awesome.
Yeah, the youngest person currently using our products for their health and wellness goals is 4. The oldest is well into their 90s. And
wow.
They're using it for such a wide variety of goals. It's very interesting to sit on the phone and talk with our customers, not only to hear the kinds of questions they're asking, but also the kinds of feedback and success stories that we hear as well. It's wonderful.
So I'll be a devil's advocate, because that's what I do. You made a comment, and we'll just let Tamar talk about this a little bit. We've talked about it before, actually. I'm a firm believer, have been for years, and people used to say, oh, you're nuts. I don't know what you're talking about. hemp oil in your diet as preventative medicine. Mm-hmm. You briefly touched on it. I'm not going to quote you exactly, but I heard you mention it. You know, with your immune system, you know, mm-hmm. people with weakened immune systems. How does it help to do something like build your immune system?
Well, I'm glad you actually asked that. Recently, I think, CB2 receptors were found on immune cells. And although CBD doesn't interact directly with any CB receptors, that list of constituents that I listed earlier, the entourage effect of ingesting hemp oil would increase your immune response. It would keep all your immune cells and your system basically revved up just in case you were to get sick. And I don't know if you, I mean, do you get sick often? Are you an active consumer? consumer?
I consume actively, definitely, but I...
It's a requirement of Overgrow the Radio. We may be political and professional, but you have to be pretty okay with cannabis.
Right. I just know personally, since I've been ingesting, I rarely get sick. Mm-hmm. So as far as immunity, as I said, hemp oil, ingesting that would prepare your system for any kind of biological, microbial, or viral attack.
Well, do you guys, well, on a side note, on a non-Dixie note, and we'll pretend that there's no bosses in the room and no bosses will ever watch this. You know, Dr. Bob, Robert Melamed's a good friend of mine, and again, he's backed me up and made me feel confident in this, that, you know, there's a cannabis deficiency, or in this case, hemp, I think is the same thing. And I'm going to let you explain that for the, you know, two people in the world who don't know this yet. but I firmly believe what you just said. I don't get sick. I never get colds and flus, as I knock on wood. You know, it's something that I believe, but I'm going to let you tell us why that's true.
Well, actually, the endocannabinoid system was only discovered because the research into CBD and THC. It was an unknown system, and the endo, the ECS, shorthand, the ECS is kind of a modulator system. It oversees almost every system in the body. Not only that, but it interacts with other neurotransmitter systems like serotonin, dopamine. It controls your mood, appetite, stabilization, immunity, as we were discussing. So a lot of deficiencies like fibromyalgia or migraines, these diseases that don't really have a medical basis, are being discovered could possibly be a deficiency in the ECS, because when exocannabinoids are added, THC, CBD, these ailments reverse themselves and fix themselves. So the research is actually very exciting, and there's a lot more being done. So
it is exciting.
Mm-hmm. It is. And I'm not sure. I'm assuming business is doing well. I know that I've been, our next guest, Allie, just got off of some charges down in El Paso County. We get to pick on Dan May again tonight, and he makes it so easy. And someday he'll, I'm hoping someday he'll get past this and realize that this war is over.
Maybe one day you'll have him on the show.
I would love that.
I know. I would love to see that.
The offer's been extended.
If he is brave enough.
Many...
He'd have
well,
to be.
Well, I mean, we've talked... excuse me, a couple of weeks ago when Cliff Black and Bob were on after Bob got his meds back, I have a phone relationship, if you will, with the PIO in Dan May's office. She tries to dodge my calls, but, you know, I'm pretty good at getting her on the air. So we've definitely got them to at least answer questions on the show, whether they chose to or not, and put the salesman face on and got them to say things they probably really didn't want to say. But the cool thing with that is in Colorado in particular, as long as one person knows that you're recording the conversation, Absolutely. It's perfectly legal.
And with 64 passing, law enforcement, government agencies, this is a tax and regulate like alcohol situation. So they will come on board. It's just a matter of it's adult use, it's responsible use. And Dixie is a huge advocate of what that means.
Absolutely.
That's why we're so interested in compliance, because we've invested a lot of money and time and effort, blood, sweat, and tears into our product lines and our intellectual capacity that it would be silly not to be compliant, not to be political, and not be focused on serving either customers or patients and getting that educational message out there.
Well, and that's, of course, I got sidetracked, and that's where I was going was when I stopped in Allie's place for the first time. The huge selection now of Dixie products is impressive. you guys run the gamut.
It's legendary.
Well, and you know, I pitch you guys, and I've been teaching people what you taught me, ma'am, that if they use the CBD line or CBD products in general and then use things with THC, it helps increase their buzz or their medication. No one's going to argue with that. It's a huge selling point. So I've definitely been getting the word out about that. I've been in like 3 or 4 dispensaries where you guys are all over the place. So
that's great to hear.
It's good to see, you know, not only just your medicated products, but as well as the botanicals line that they're carrying those.
So are you guys going to be in other stores? You know, any stores that just the everyday person could go in?
Absolutely.
And find?
Across the United States, you're beginning to see this hemp oil wellness product line in chiropractic stores, spas, salons, health and wellness stores, oncology, supplement stores, those kinds of places. It's really picking up speed. And I don't know if you're familiar with Dr. Circus at all, but he's a doctor that wrote an amazing piece on CBD wellness, hemp oil wellness. And his name is, what is it? Circus, Dr. Circus, that was just an amazing piece and a very educational piece. The, you know, Dixie's in the media a lot. We've taken the stance that, you know, what we're doing is good for patients, good for people, and now good for customers. And a lot of people say, oh, Dixie's too big, we're too out there, but we're really trying to be the face of medical cannabis and responsible stewardship of a fledgling industry.
Well, you guys, you are. I mean, absolutely. I say time and time again, we wouldn't work with you if you weren't professional and on the forefront of things. I didn't mean to cut you off, but we are going to take one more break real quick.
Okay.
So be patient with me, and I'm really not rude, I promise.
We'll be back.
We love you. We'll be right back.
We love you, too.
Dixie Elixirs and Edibles, the patient's choice for alternative medical marijuana treatment. Dixie Elixirs infused sparkling beverages. Dixie Edibles, Dewdrops, Tonics, and Dixie Scripps Extraordinarily Concentrated Cannabis Extract Capsules, along with Dixie Botanicals, all natural topical therapy. All of these medicinal remedies are available at your local medical marijuana center. Like us on Facebook, Dixie Elixirs, or join us at www.dixieelixirs.com.
The Law Offices of Vets and Maiden and Mats provide criminal defense, medical marijuana defense, and advice about setting up and running medical marijuana centers, optional premises, cultivation operations, and infused product manufacturing businesses throughout Colorado. With offices in Denver and Aspen, we can offer assistance throughout the entire state of Colorado. Give us a call at 303-831-8188. That's 303-831-8188. Or visit us online at warrenetson.com.
Hi, I'm Josh Stanley.
And I'm Jesse Stanley.
Two of the brothers here from National Geographic's American Weed, and we'd like to invite you to come into our dispensaries in Dispensary in Colorado Springs. Come in for the most pure organic strain selection in Colorado. It's all hand-grown by the Stanley brothers, especially for our patients. So come in and visit us at our two locations, East Platte and West Colorado. And remember,
always be kind to each other.
We Grow Colorado, the premier medical marijuana dispensary in Colorado Springs, is proud to be a part of the medical marijuana community. We Grow Colorado works hard to make every patient feel comfortable and informed. With a great selection of medical cannabis in multiple forms, the patient finds many premium choices to aid in their self-treatment. The staff at We Grow Colorado is another large part of what makes We Grow Colorado the number one choice for many patients throughout the state. Visit them today at 2502 East Bijou Street in Colorado Springs for an experience that will last and laugh.
Let's face it, rules and regulations are complicated, especially in the field of medical marijuana. Let Medical Marijuana 101 help you get through the compliance process. We can also explain to you your employment requirements, your employees, and your business. But our work doesn't stop there. Our experience in cultivation ranges from the design of grow rooms to the diagnosis and resolution of grow problems. Visit us at www.medicalmarijuana101.com. Or call 303-388-7706. That's 303-388-7706.
Ah, we're back on Overgrowth Radio. Sometimes Sam catches me off guard. I think I'm ready, but I'm not. So here we are. We're still joined by two lovely, intelligent ladies at the end of the table down there, Miss Christy and Tamar. And I'm sorry, I forgot my lovely co-host and intelligent, Holly G. And Sam, you're lovely too.
Thanks.
you know.
He's quite lovely, actually.
Somebody's got to do the producing here.
Oh, Christy, you don't ever stop.
I am a born matchmaker.
She likes to flatter people, make us feel good about ourselves.
Yeah. Definitely.
Anyway, you guys, Dixie, well, in the last 6 months, year, you guys have been nominated for a lot of fun awards. You've won a lot of awards.
We have. It's been an exciting year.
We had, I think, one of my funnest awards interviews, if you will, with you guys, absolutely, at the THC party. It was broadcast, but it was never released again. I'm pretty sure it's blackmail footage. So
I have no idea what you're speaking about, Stickman. Tamar, do you have any recollection of this evening? No.
I think that's the problem right there. So moving on.
It's in the clouds.
I was told to be businesslike, so we'll move on from that. You guys... coming up there, and we've been plugging this vaguely because I don't know all the details like I should. There's a couple events coming up, one here in Denver and then one in the Springs, and we'll talk about the Springs in a minute. The one here in Denver is at Castleman's on the 19th, and a friend of the station studio and actually one of our owners, Georgia, are responsible for this, I believe, the ball. And I want to let you guys talk about it because not only are you nominated, or you got nominated, but now you're in the – you need to be voted on to win.
Yeah.
So tell us what you got nominated for again.
So we received a couple different nominations. One was Most Valuable Medical Cannabis Business, Dixie Elixirs. The other one was a award geared specifically for MIPS, Manufacturer of Infused Products, which was Dixie Elixirs again. And then Trip Kieber, the CEO of Red Dice Incorporated and also Dixie Elixirs as well, he was nominated as Hemp Business Person of the Year, which is really exciting for us because we have done some really amazing things this year, thanks to the science team, Tamar and Darwin and everyone at the production facility. And, you know, you will not find a group of people who are more passionate about hemp and the different constituents of the plant and the history of the plant, and that it's been a companion, as I'm very fond of saying, of mankind. And there's just so much potential. So it's really an honor to be nominated, and it's a white ball. There is going to be a silent auction to benefit the Hyde family, and Cash Hyde will receive a, I'm not very good at pronouncing the award, but...
it'll go to the foundation, the Cash Hyde Foundation.
Yeah.
We had Mike on last
year.
Week, and you know, as I've mentioned, they're family to me, and it's great to see just the outpouring, not just here or in Montana, but across the globe. It's unreal to see people. Yeah, the kid was a light and remains to be a light for everyone.
Absolutely.
So I nominated you guys. I'm sure a lot of people did. I voted for you. I will admit I was a little torn on the hemp category, and I won't tell anyone which way I voted, but we all know Jason Law wrote the
Absolutely.
Hemp bill that's being implemented. And I think this is a great segue because into what we want to touch on before we get out of time here. You guys, with you guys, hemp is your bread and butter, or, you know, a big part of it. A side of 64 that's really being ignored right now is the hemp side.
Yeah.
I mean, horribly ignored. We're underestimating the potential of the hemp side of it, the growth in jobs. You know, I laughed. I sat in a council meeting in the Springs a couple weeks ago where you know, we're fighting about fracking right now, and no matter which way you feel, one of the arguments from the council was, well, it brings in jobs. And this is from a city council who has never opposed anything but decided to oppose Amendment 64, minus Tim Lee, who his response to that was he sang Puff the Magic Dragon, which was awesome. I don't remember what publication, but one of the printed publications said, well, Mr. Lee, how did you feel about it? And he literally sang Puff the Magic Dragon.
Nice.
Amazing. But, you know, the irony here is they vote against hemp, which could bring in hundreds, if not, I mean, thousands of jobs, theoretically, to just our county. And, you know, we're doing this and we're pitching fracking that's going to bring in at most 80 jobs, and maybe half of those might actually be residents of Colorado.
And it'll be devastating to our natural resources, where hemp is a growth industry. It's a green industry. It's a amazing cycle of growth. It within 3 months, you get plants that are literally 12 to 16 feet tall. It adds nutrients to the soil. It requires very little water and very little fertilizer to grow. And my hat's off to Jason Love as a hemp advocate in the state of Colorado. He wrote the Hemp Remediation Act of 2012, which Governor Hickenlooper signed into effect on July 4th of this year. And then the hemp part of 64 just further outlines and solidifies our opportunity to have hemp growing in the United States for the first time since the mid-30s.
So
very exciting. It's
exciting.
It is. It's absolutely very exciting, yeah.
Well, and as I said earlier, it's very important in a lot of aspects the way we move forward from here. And that's not being addressed. And what I want to propose to Dixie and you guys, and you can pass this up the chain, is that there is some sort of group, I don't want to use the word task force, but group of hemp minds, if you will, like Jason, yourself. You know, the cool thing for folks outside of Colorado that don't get to see the way we interact is we, as a group of activists in Colorado, we can be at each other's throat, pro and against 64. Mm-hmm. But when important things, you know, and I'm totally getting sidetracked a little bit, but it's just inspiring to see the folks that have jumped back on now that 64 has passed and said, okay, I didn't like it. I even fought against it, but now we've got it. We've got to move forward and we've got to do it together. Mm-hmm. The moral of that story is we're all a big family and we all end up working mm-hmm. together even when we butt heads like families do.
Absolutely.
I think we, and I'm not really the knowledgeable guy to do so, but I would love to sit and be the fly on the wall. I would love to see you guys throw together a group of hemp-minded people to help this government move forward. They, by law, have to implement something regarding hemp by 2014.
Absolutely. And there's a whole generation of knowledge about hemp, which we've lost, potentially. Dixie's obviously very interested in hemp production, and we sponsored Jason Love's trip to go to Canada I think it was November, the first week of November. He spoke at a Canadian hemp industry meeting. So Dixie is a huge part of the hemp movement, just as we were a huge part of the medical cannabis movement, and we're innovators and very interested in breaking new ground. And I, for one, know there's a lot of unused, underutilized farmland I'm from the Western Slope, so I call this the Eastern Slope.
The Plains.
But I grew up in Grand Junction, Palisade, and what we could do to the soil quality there is amazing. And we could also grow our food, our clothes, mm-hmm. our building resources, and also the amazing constituents that are in this hemp oil that Dixie uses. It's a full service plant. It's an amazing thing. So yeah, Dixie, you know, you're kind of hedging around it. So I'll get down to the brass tacks. Yes, we're very interested in having fields of hemp. What that timing looks like, I'm not aware. We currently don't have any specific plans to start growing hemp, but things move very quickly at Dixie. So you never know what the future holds.
Well, I'm sorry, go ahead, Holly.
Oh, I just wanted to pop in because we had a quick question from a chatter in the chat room. For Tamar, are the classic dewdrops alcohol-based? Mm-hmm. And they also want to know if there's any new flavors that are offered aside the cinnamon flavor.
So the classic or...
It says the Dixie Classic Dewdrops.
Okay. So both our Classic and our Dixie Botanicals, they are not alcohol-based. They actually have no alcohol in them. And the second question, I'm sorry. Oh, the new flavors. Mm-hmm. As for the Dixie Botanicals, we did start with cinnamon. We are working on new flavors for both the the botanicals and our classic line. With that said, we haven't really decided on them, so I will let you know a little later.
They're still in the Willy Wonka phase of the factory.
We do a lot of product testing and development, and in the Dixie Elixirs and the Edibles line that we've referred to internally as the classic line, and it's caught on a little bit outside because it really is a classic. We are going to add cinnamon to that line, and then we were knocking around ginger, mango, and
some orange tangerine too.
Orange tangerine. So we're very interested in hearing what you guys want for flavors in tincture. Mm-hmm. If you go onto our Facebook page, please feel free to post your thoughts there.
What's that? How do people find your Facebook page?
And just type in Dixie Elixirs on Facebook, and it pops up. We are everywhere. But yeah, thank you for that great question. And you know, we're really interested in hearing what flavors you would like. Absolutely.
And we're, of course, out of time pretty much, because that's what we do when we talk to people we like, is we just talk and talk and talk, and there you go. It's the way it happens. Thank you, ladies, so much for another amazing segment. DixieElixirs.com, is that correct?
That's correct.
I always get confused on whether there's an S there.
It is. It's DixieElixirs.com.
Yes. So I was good there. And also DixieX.com.
For the time being, and we'll be launching that new website very, very soon, probably right after the Christmas holiday, and that'll be DixieBotanicals.com.
And I just want to add that really my first, I guess, discovery of you guys was through your tincture. And a big problem that I have, theoretically, morally, whatever you want to say, and I know it might be a little ridiculous, is I don't drink. So all the tincture had alcohol. And I'm like, I don't like that taste. I don't like the alcohol taste. So I found you guys. I've been using the tincture ever since. I know a lot of patients who feel the same way. And there's probably a lot of patients who don't know that it's without alcohol. Yeah. So I'm sorry I haven't mentioned that in previous segments.
That's
I should have.
That's a good question.
So yeah, absolutely. So what we're going to do now, again, we'll see you guys soon. And,
Thank you, guys.
We didn't really talk about the holidays, but I'm not a big Christian guy, but I still like Christmas. I like food and cookies. So whatever you're doing, whatever your beliefs, have a great holiday season and a safe holiday season. And we look forward to moving forward with
Happy
the end of New Year.
Happy New Year.
Yeah.
And we look forward to seeing you in January. We
Absolutely.
Really are so happy to be part of the iCannabis family and look forward to a very long relationship. So.
Well, we're lucky to have you guys, and Tamar is our favorite because I get to learn from her.
Thank you.
But right now I'm going to go make myself a little slightly stupid to steal the name of a band and get my back right because it's giving me a hard time today.
Time for a break.
We'll be back in a few. Enjoy some music from our lovely, lovely producer, Sam.
Hi, Josh Stanley here from National Geographic's American Weed. I'm here with my brothers, and we've just recently put together a foundation in Colorado to allow for cancer patients and other patients of debilitating conditions to be able to get a hold of cannabis-based oil that's just about free of charge. I've just about had it with seeing sick patients suffer needlessly just because they can't afford the proper medication. That's what the Realm of Caring is going to change. Visit therealmofcaring.com. The website will be complete and up on 4/20 of 2012. But until then, please contact any of us Stanley brothers directly through email. You can get us at gratefuljosh@hotmail.com. Now come on, Colorado. We need to take care of each other. Join the realm. That's realmofcaring.com. Thank you so much.
The Hemp Connoisseur is Colorado's premier guide to hemp culture. Our mission is to elevate the image of the medical cannabis and hemp industries to create widespread acceptance for all of the uses of the cannabis plant. You can find the Hemp Connoisseur in over 200 7-Elevens, your local dispensary, MMJ doctor offices, and tattered covered bookstores. Also, visit us online at thcmag.com or download our brand new app for your smartphone.
The law offices of Etzen, Maiden, and Matz provide criminal defense, medical marijuana defense, and advice about setting up and running medical marijuana centers, optional premises, cultivation operations, and infused product manufacturing businesses throughout Colorado. With offices in Denver and Aspen, we can offer assistance throughout the entire state of Colorado. Give us a call at 303
303-831-8188. That's 303-831-8188. Or visit us online at warrenedson.com.
Face it, rules and regulations are complicated, especially in the field of medical marijuana. Let Medical Marijuana 101 help you get through the compliance process. We can also explain to you your employment requirements, your employees, and your business. But our work doesn't stop there. Our experience in cultivation ranges from the design of grow rooms to the diagnosis and resolution of grow problems. Visit us at www.medicalmarijuana101.com or call 303-388-7706. That's 303-388-7706. Are you a runner? Are you a runner who supports marijuana legalization? Run on Grass is a group of athletes actively seeking to change our marijuana laws. We speak the truth about cannabis, bringing the message through our feet to new ears. Check out runongrass.com to find out more about us, our events, and how to join up or how to sponsor a runner. If you're in the Denver area, please join us for runs or start a group in your area. Running not your thing? Any sport can do it. On Grass. Runongrass.com.
Dixie Elixirs and Edibles, the patient's choice for alternative medical marijuana treatment. Dixie Elixirs infuse sparkling beverages. Dixie Edibles, Dewdrops, Tonics, and Dixie Scripts extraordinarily concentrated cannabis extract capsules, along with Dixie Botanicals, all natural topical therapy. All of these medicinal remedies are available at your local medical marijuana center. Like us on Facebook, Dixie Elixirs, or join us at www.dixieelixirs.com.
And we're back here on Overgrow the Radio. Hope everybody has enjoyed our music break, and thank you to all our sponsors.
I hope everyone got medicated.
That's Stickman there, and he got his back right in the break, so we're
how can you tell? Because of the smile or because I'm not like cringed over here in pain?
Yeah, you look very relaxed over there.
I try. Yeah. I've been a lot of cops around my world lately.
I heard you were tailed on the way to the studio.
Well, yeah, we didn't get to talk about them coming to my house, did we? In the first hour.
You touched on it a little bit,
I think. They came and visited the house and wrote down plate numbers and walked up our neighbor's driveway, looked in our backyard. You know, I think what happened is our power bill last month took a crazy spike. Don't know why. Not happy about it. Don't like to give them more money. And they obviously don't like me in El Paso County, as we'll talk about with the next guest a little bit, I'm sure. Because I do call out Dan May constantly. It's ridiculous what he does, him prosecuting caregivers who abide by the law. I mean, he's 0-7 on big cannabis cases.
And this happens in a lot of counties.
So, yeah, I get a random call just saying the cops are at the house, an unmarked SUV and a uniformed officer in a squad car. And the disturbing part, I think, is not only, you know, was I not there, the fact that they walk up and look behind a privacy fence is a little, you know, sketchy. Exactly. But then they come back an hour later and sit there until like 4 a.m. in their SUV.
Crazy.
Yeah.
Well, hopefully you should go up and knock on their window and say, hey.
Well, what I didn't get to say during news or when I touched on it earlier is, you know, it's no big secret who I am to them. My God, I can't use the word harass because they've tried to bring harassment charges against me, but I've talked to them all the DAs. I've dealt with all the police in down there with Occupy and different things. I'm sure they have my phone number. If not, call Lee, the PIO at Dan May's office. I know she has my phone number. You know, don't creep around my yard like some hoodlum. You know, it's no wonder police or people...
Be up front.
Well, it's no wonder, like, the guy in Arizona who was ex-military, the cops were looking in his window before they raid his house. He comes out with an AK, they kill him. It's no wonder people do that. What do you do when someone's, like, sneaking through your yard?
I don't know. And speaking of, you know, someone that has been getting prosecuted by police, our next guest, I think we're about to give her a call, Allie Hillary. She's from where you're from, Colorado Springs, isn't that right?
Yeah.
So yeah. I'm interested to hear about her case and what's going on with that.
The 4th Judicial District covers El Paso, Teller, that area down in that area. And Dan May is our head DA, and you know,
we are not available.
We're gonna try another number.
Allie, are you there?
We're gonna try the second number.
She's getting her back right.
Right, exactly. She's getting prepped for the interview. But yeah, he, you know, what he's done, what we've talked about before with different people that have beat him, is he's taking this crazy hardline stance. Here we are, we just passed legalization for any adult over 21. And he's still picking on patients. And I mean, we've had medical for 12 years. 12 years.
That's a while.
Yes.
Hello?
Hey.
Allie.
Is this Allie?
Is this Allie?
Hold on 1 second.
Oh. We've almost got
Turn your computer down.
We can hear
Getting
your computer.
Feedback.
Hello.
Hey, Allie. It's Stickman and Holly G. How are you?
I'm good, Harris. How are you?
We're doing good. We're doing good. We were just ranting about Dan May a little bit. We can hear a little bit of feedback if somebody has a computer on right by you there.
The iPad is on.
That might be. We sort of introduced you, but, you know, you've been busy with your trial, and then after the trial, I, you know, played phone tag a couple times and was in and out of your place. And I know how life can be after the trial. It's a little busy. So I apologize for not knowing all of the details. So what I want to do is kind of jump in. You know, I talked about you being the latest person to kick Dan May's butt in court. That's awesome. Kudos. Congratulations. It's definitely, I'm sure, a huge weight off of your shoulders and your family. Both?
Yes.
So explain to us, Allie, what exactly happened with you?
Well, the MMED came to visit my shop and said that I was growing too many plants for the patient count that I had. And I told them that I thought their list was incorrect. We were in the process of putting in a new POS system. And so I think that's where the confusion came in. I'm not real sure. But anyway, I had explained to them on the second day they arrived with law enforcement, and I tried to tell them at that point, because I wasn't there when they first came. So I tried to tell them that the list they had was incorrect and that I would get them an updated list, but they didn't want to hear anything about that. They told me they could find more wrong with the list that they had in their hand if I wanted them to. They were kind of on a mission. They just, it was the Colorado Springs Police Department.
Well, and that's, to jump in real quick, that's deja vu a little bit back to Elisa Kappelman's case where, you know, they essentially did the same thing with the patient list, and she tried to present it, and VNI just ignores it.
Right. Mm-hmm. Yeah, they didn't want to hear anything about it, not even the MMED. So, and there were two of them. So anyway, they were on a mission. They cut down more than, you know, like, I guess about half our garden. They cut down over 600 plants. They took 30-some pounds of dry, and so they said it was dry, but they actually took my wet harvest, and that's where all the weight come from. But and then they charged me with two felonies.
Did they save all your wet product and your dry product, or did they?
I have no idea.
So you don't.
The plants, they actually cut the stalk and stuffed them into burlap sacks. The 600 plants that they took.
Right.
I think it was like 604 or something like that. And then the dry product and the wet product that was still in the process of curing and drying, they put those in paper bags, big paper bags.
And sealed them up.
So I would think that after 9 months, it might not be very good.
Right. It's probably going to be molded.
Well, and I want to get to to what your next steps are in this. You know, I actually was very lucky. I got to go with Bob Krause and be the photo guy and take the pictures when he got his meds back. And it absolutely, I mean, there's no value to it anymore. I mean, his went almost 2 years, but at 9 months even, that's, people don't understand. It degrades.
Right. It's like any perishable. It's a plant. If it's not kept properly, then it perishes. So,
yeah,
I don't know.
In the law, it's supposed to be, they're supposed to keep them alive. In the law.
Oh, absolutely. Well, there's case law out of, I believe, Larimer County that says that they are supposed to keep them alive during trial. I think the problem with case law is it's just that. It's case law. It doesn't transfer.
Does it say anything in Amendment 20?
No.
Doesn't it say in Amendment 20 that they have to keep it alive?
Tamar, I see your wheels turning over there. Anyone? Yeah, that's a good question. You know, I don't think it does because it's absolutely come up, you know, in the cases and the trials that I've sat through. I know, you know, there was the one ruling in district court that said that, yes, they have to keep them alive. But we're trying
to fix an echo.
I think the echo might be coming on your iPad there if you're really close to it.
Can you turn it off?
Okay.
Or move away just a little.
Hang on a second.
Thank you.
What I can do here.
We want to give everyone the most optimum listening quality possible.
Yeah, I think that's better. Yeah.
No, we still hear it there. If you just completely turn it off, it should be better.
Okay, let's see if this is any better.
Beautiful. Maybe. Anyway.
Okay.
On
we go.
Yeah, there we go. It went down a little. But yeah, the VNI, you know, I'm going to digress because I like to get details and call these folks out. You dealt with two of my favorite culprits, for lack of a better word, with VNI. Didn't you deal with both Limpkuhl and Bain?
I believe so.
And what was your impression of the people that they actually send in to deal with you as a business owner? Were you treated in a professional manner?
I was treated like they were there on a raid, basically. They didn't want to hear anything I had to say. Matter of fact, they had even told my employees the day before that they didn't even need me there.
So you were treated like a criminal.
Well, you're not treated very nicely.
Yeah, I can
assume
that.
Just that there was no, like, basically, you could say that.
Well, they are notorious for that.
You're treated guilty.
Hey, did you get to meet Summer Solly? He's one of their undercovers.
I don't believe so.
Well, I tried to take a funny little antidote. We're going to have to take a break in a minute, but we'll lead to break. I was at Bob's trial, and he testified, and I tried to take his photo out in the hallway, and he literally ran from me, jumped in the elevator, and when I turned the corner to the elevator, he jumped back out of the elevator and ran and hid behind a little 5-foot-tall assistant DA, a female. screaming the whole time, "Don't do it, dude, don't do it." So these guys, they're bullies, but then when the tables are turned, they get really, really scared. So, Allie, if you'll stick around, we've got a lot more to talk about in your ordeal. But right now we've got to pay a few bills because that's the way the world works.
Alrighty.
So we'll be right back. And everyone, thanks for tuning in and stick with us here on Overgrowth Radio on iCannabis Radio. Peace.
Dixie Elixirs and Edibles, the nation's premier infused product manufacturer, brings you the newest in hemp CBD wellness products, Dixie X. Derived from CBD for medicinal hemp, this non-psychoactive cannabinoid provides the medicinal effects of cannabis, but without the high. Join the Dixie X revolution today at www.dixiex.com or like us on Facebook,
Dixie X or Dixie Elixirs.
The law offices of Etzen, Maiden, and Matz provide criminal defense, medical marijuana defense, and advice about setting up and running medical marijuana centers, optional premises, cultivation operations, and infused product manufacturing businesses throughout Colorado. With offices in Denver and Aspen, we can offer assistance throughout the entire state of Colorado. Give us a call at 303-831-8188. That's 303-831-8188. Or visit us online at warrenetzen.com.
That Mad Hatter Smoke Shop has everything from space glass to butane and butane accessories, I tell you what. Located at 6091 West Colfax in Lakewood, and now at 2615 Walnut Street in Denver. Oh, God damn it, Reclaim, put your pants back on.
We Grow Colorado, the premier medical marijuana dispensary in Colorado Springs, is proud to be a part of the medical marijuana community. We Grow Colorado works hard to make every patient feel comfortable and informed. With a great selection of medical cannabis in multiple forms, the patient finds many premium choices to aid in their self-treatment. The staff at We Grow Colorado is another large part of what makes We Grow Colorado the number one choice for many patients throughout the state. Visit them today at 2502 East Bijou Street in Colorado Springs for an experience that will last and last.
Dixie Elixirs and Edibles, the patient's choice for alternative medical marijuana treatment. Dixie Elixirs infuse sparkling beverages. Dixie Edibles, Dewdrops, Tonics, and Dixie Scripts extraordinarily concentrated cannabis extract capsules, along with Dixie Botanicals, all natural topical therapy. All of these medicinal remedies are available at your local medical marijuana center. Like us on Facebook, Dixie Elixirs, or join us at www.dixieelixirs.com.
And we're back on Over to Grow the Radio. Holly G was like taking a hit and totally missed that cue.
Oops. But you're here on iCannabis Radio, so I want to, you know, just because
you
I was missing my cue, but it's okay.
She didn't feel like she was being a good enough co-host. She needed to be a little more medicated.
But we have Allie Hillary here on the phone, and we've been chatting a little bit about what she's had to go through and all the pain that the police officers and just getting raided has taken her through, and now... we definitely want to find out more about her case and what she went through.
Welcome back, Allie.
Thank you.
I want to digress for just a second way back, because I was able to be there for the opening arguments in your case or your trial.
Uh-huh.
And then I wasn't, because life throws curveballs sometimes. But what I did hear is a very unique story as to how you got into the medical marijuana business, if you will.
Sure. My son had stage 4 bladder cancer. And so that's why we really got into the business end of it. And since then, we've been able to help a whole lot of people. So my son is cancer-free right now.
Awesome.
Mm-hmm. It really helped him through the chemotherapy that he had, and I believe it'll keep him from getting cancer in the future if he continues to take preventative measures with Phoenix Tears.
With hemp oil?
Yes, it is.
Yeah, we actually one of our big sponsors is Dixie, and we talked a little bit tonight about the difference between some of their oils and the tears. And I use, what's Realm Oil, the Realm of Caring, for back pain.
Does it have THC in it?
Absolutely.
It does, okay.
Yeah, a lot of THC. And it's basically the equivalent of Phoenix Tears. I just like to use Realm Oil because that's their branding, you know?
Right, for sure.
But it does amazing things. It's apoptosis. It goes in and confuses the cancer cells, and the cancer cells commit suicide, essentially. And you know, I think it's awesome, that story. And you named, I mean Rocky Mountain Miracles, that was named after your son, right?
Yeah.
What's Rocky Mountain Miracles?
Her business.
That is the medical marijuana dispensary.
So you're located in Colorado Springs?
Yes, we are.
You're actually one of our other sponsors is just a few doors down from you. Drew down at WeGrow is a sponsor of the show. He used to do a segment. He had to take a little hiatus because of the holidays. But, you know, I drove by your guys' place a million times and had never been in. And since I've been in, I've gotten, I don't know, four or five different strains. I've been really impressed. So.
Oh, cool.
I'm pretty picky, huh? Quick side note.
Very good.
So,
yeah, we have a lot of strains, that's for sure.
Yeah, you do. You have a very good selection, and it's all organic dirt grown. Mm-hmm. You know, I could go on and on. I could make an ad for you guys real quick.
How long have you been growing cannabis?
We just kind of got started. For myself, just when we started this business, I think in 2010, January.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Great.
Well, let's, before we get short on time, because we're good at that, let's jump back into the proceedings as to what happened. And I want to paint a picture, because you weren't able to get up here with us tonight so folks can see you. You're an... I don't want to say older lady, but you're older than me.
That's all right. I'm a grandma.
You're a grandma. That's a good way to put it. We'll say that. You're a grandma.
Yeah, I got 10 grandchildren.
And people even call you. You've even got a nickname that is like Granny Ganja, I've heard.
Granny of Ganja, yeah.
Awesome.
Granny of Ganja. You are the type of person, and I don't know you that well. I'm sure we'll get to know each other in the future. But you're the type of person that people, you know, my friend Daryl says he called you Ma the first day he met you. So.
A lot of people call me Mom because all of my kids work there.
Well, and you're not, I guess my point is you're not the stereotypical person. When people from the outside look at the industry, I think they like to picture all of us having dreadlocks and being in our 20s.
Right.
Right.
And I think the point being that Dan May, our DA, is not going after those people. He's going after people who are doing things right.
We're certainly trying. you know, 200 pages of rules. It's a very regulated industry, very difficult to keep up with all the paperwork and so on. But for anybody that owns a dispensary, they're not in it to deal out the back door. They're in it to make a business and to help people. So I'm impressed with all of us that have been able to stay in business thus far. It's very difficult.
I'm sure they put a lot of terms out there that are tough to meet.
Mm-hmm. Well, and you just hit on it, and it was brought up in your trial that the regulations are ever changing, and especially in the last couple of years, and to try to keep up with that has to be just overwhelming.
Yep. Well, forms change, new rules come out, but even the state can't keep up with it. So, and that came out in my trial, too, that they're 3 months behind on patient status change forms, and it's still taking about 8-9 weeks for my patients, anyway, to get their red cards or to get a renewal. So sure. It's very difficult for the state to even keep up with all the changes.
Well, and you'll love this. I just saw today that they're going to revise. There's going to be a vast revision of all of the rules, and there's a rough draft coming out, I believe, in January.
So were you able to rebuild right away for your patients after you were raided, or was it a long...
No, it's taken us about 9 months. It's cost me a lot of money to purchase. I had to purchase product from other dispensaries. And I was pretty picky, so because, you know, I wanted a quality product for them, so I traveled just about all over the state to try to get product in there. And we did keep it stocked, but it cost us severely. I haven't made any money at this business since we started. You know, just between all the fees, your application fees, your pre-application fees,
with the city and the state, your camera systems, having to purchase product and hire attorneys, and the costs just go on and on and on. It's really difficult to make a dollar in this business these days with all the difficulties.
Yeah, especially if you're not able to grow your own medicine.
Right. Mm-hmm. It's taken us the full 9 months to recover and get to the growing point where we were before the raid.
Oh, I'm
and
sure.
I don't know why it's taken that long. It just has. And I expected it not to take us that long, but it really has taken us that long. I guess because you can only... we only have clone machines that hold so many clones, and that turnover is only every 2 weeks, and it just takes time.
Absolutely. So after I left your trial, I guess, you know, I missed the juice of the prosecution's argument. And was it pretty cut and dry once you guys presented the proper lists? Did the jury kind of have, you know, I noticed in the past that it was very apparent the jury got fed up at a certain point. Was your trial a lot like that, or what happened?
My jury was very, a very good jury, I'd say, because they didn't let on to me about anything, or I don't think they let on to the prosecution. You know, they took their job very seriously, and they listened intently to everything, but it took them about 30 minutes or not very, maybe 45 minutes. I don't know. It didn't take them very long to decide to come up with a verdict. And so I was really surprised how quickly we were hearing the verdict. So
that's impressive.
Yeah.
You know, I think... The other two trials I was in, I thought was fast, and it was 4 to 5 hours.
Oh, wow. Yeah. Well, you know, the state pretty much, well, just said that because it looked like a clerical error that I should have at least had a warning of some sort, but I'd really never even been visited by for any kind of inspection. I'd just never been visited at all by anyone. And then the first time they visit me, they just want to come in and cut everything down.
Well, and
they did.
It was mentioned in trial. You guys were told as dispensary owners that they would do that, correct?
Well, Dan Hartman was the person that was head of MMED at the time of my raid back in March, and he said that that protocol would have been to give me a warning first and to try to help centers to get compliant. That was their goal, to try to help everybody get into compliance. And I'm sorry, I can't remember the name of the lady that took over after him.
Yeah, Laura Harris.
Right now. Who?
Laura Harris.
Yes. And she also testified to the same thing.
Yeah, I mean, and I think that is their goal. I think what happens, and the reason I continue to call Dan May out, is you have these rogue DAs like him. I mean, you're a prime example. You were following the law, and, you know, here you are, you had to fight charges.
Yes.
So what have you done since you're not guilty? That's what I want to know before we run out of time. How have you celebrated?
Well, we went from the courthouse to our shop. We were going to open up for a little while, let our patients come in, and so they could all say yay together, you know. And my daughter was in labor, so we decided we best to shut the shop quickly and get on to Denver, and had a granddaughter born the next morning at 5:40 in the morning, so that was a wonderful thing.
Congratulations. Babies are a beautiful thing. I was here earlier for one of our other shows, and Adam Dunn from Hood Lab had their baby in with them, a little cutie.
Oh, nice. Yeah.
We played pinball.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. He's probably all of 6 months old, but he liked the lights, you know?
Oh, yeah, I bet.
So what are your plans? I mean, did this... I know you said financially it was a killer, but did it hurt business? Have you seen people... Has it gotten your name out?
It hurt business for a while. I think the fact that, you know, I didn't get to have the product that we actually grow in my store for so many months that, of course, we had a little bit of our stuff, but not much. And I believe it has hurt business. It definitely... stop the growth rate that we were on.
Sure.
And so, you know, we haven't grown at the same rate we were growing before. So it's definitely hurt us business-wise, financially, and patient-wise. And not only that, but I like to give my first time or my patients, those that become members, we like to give them a sample of our product, and I was unable to do that. We're just now getting to where we can take patients again as members. So,
sure,
pretty excited about that.
Well, as I said, Allie, I've been in, and I absolutely recommend your guys' place. We're just about out of time. First and foremost, I want to thank you and congratulate you again. For coming on the show and for kicking Dan May's butt.
Do you have a website or a page that people can find out more?
Oh, yes, about? I sure do. It's RockyMountainMiracles.com.
RockyMountainMiracles.com.
And you're right there on Bijou in Colorado Springs. I encourage everyone to go get some good organic from the earth cannabis from Miss Allie and her wonderful family.
Thank you very much.
I have to say, the first time I was in there and I met your daughter, she won my heart because I'm kind of a lovey hippie guy. And I got ready to leave, and she's like, "You got to give me a hug. I don't shake hands."
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, we hug a lot of our patients.
That's
pretty much. I like everyone to feel at home in our place.
Absolutely, so, and I did. It's wonderful.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
Thank you so much.
I will be in again soon, and you enjoy the rest of your evening.
Okay, and is this Georgia, too, that I'm speaking with?
Holly G.
Holly?
Yes. Yes.
Well, you stop in to see me, too, okay, Holly?
Okay, I will do that.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys.
I'm excited,
too. Thank you for all your work. Bye-bye. Well,
before we cut away, we can't cut away yet. Okay. Oh, no, you can go, Allie. I'm sorry.
Oh, okay.
I've got to give a shout-out to all of our sponsors because they're all wonderful. In Dispensary down in Colorado Springs, they've got a couple locations on Platt and out on Colorado. Wonderful strains.
RockyMountainMiracles.com.
Well, Rocky Mountain Miracles, we'll give them a plug just because we love them. And, you know, I have been in there a few times, and the last couple of times it was busy. So I hope people are paying some love there. You know, it is hard.
And our sponsors are
that.
Awesome, too. So you can go visit both on one shot.
Yeah. RealmOfCaring.com. The Realm of Caring, everybody should be donating trim, as we've been talking about tonight with the Phoenix Tears. It's essential we get that medicine to sick people. So realmofcaring.com, Independent Records, damn cool place. Like 7, 8, 9, 10 locations all up and down the Front Range. When you see mountains, look for a record store, and that'll be Independent. It's really easy.
With a pipe shop.
Yeah. Green Monster Glass, great guys. Daryl's got a very reasonably priced glass for your dispensary and patients, and sometimes I can't talk and my tongue gets all twisted. And Dixie was in tonight, so we don't really need to plug them a lot because they got to do that themselves.
Dixie Botanicals.
Dixie Botanicals. Right now, their websites are DixieX.com and DixieElixirs.com. That will soon be changing. They'll fill us in next time. And one more, We Grow Colorado. Drew hopefully will be joining us again for a segment in the near future. They're literally, like I said, like four doors down from Allie. So you can go and grab a little from both. So again, we'll be right back. We've got to pay those guys and take one more commercial break. Then we're going to talk to Thurlow Weed. He's got a little medicated chef thing going on that I find pretty cool. So we're going to chat with him about it for a few.
Weed.
We'll be right back on Overgrowth Radio. Peace.
Dixie Elixirs and Edibles, the nation's premier infused product manufacturer, brings you the newest in hemp CBD wellness products, Dixie X. Derived from CBD from medicinal hemp, this non-psychoactive cannabinoid provides the medicinal effects of cannabis, but without the high. Join the Dixie X revolution today at www.dixiex.com. Or like us on Facebook, Dixie X or Dixie Elixirs.
The law offices of Vets and Maiden and Mats provide criminal defense, medical marijuana defense, and advice about setting up and running medical marijuana centers, optional premises, cultivation operations, and infused product manufacturing businesses throughout Colorado. With offices in Denver and Aspen, we can offer assistance throughout the entire state of Colorado. Give us a call at 303-831-8188. That's 303-831-8188. Or visit us online at warrenetson.com.
That Matt had a smoke shop has everything from space glass to butane and butane accessories. I tell you what, located at 6901 West Colfax in Lakewood, and now at 2615 Walnut Street in Denver. Oh, god damn it, Reclaim, put your pants back.
Green Monster Glass, a full selection of glass and glass accessories, as well as all of your smoking needs. Stock your dispensary or smoke shop with reasonably priced glass from Green Monster Glass. Green Monster Glass is locally owned and operated. Find us on Facebook or call Daryl at 719-217-5380. That's 719-217-5380.
Hi, Josh Stanley here from National Geographic's American Weed. I'm here with my brothers, and we've just recently put together a foundation in Colorado to allow for cancer patients and other patients of debilitating conditions to be able to get a hold of cannabis-based oil that's just about free of charge. I've just about had it with seeing sick patients suffer needlessly just because they can't afford the proper medication. That's what the Realm of Caring is going to change. Visit therealmofcaring.com. The website will be complete and up on 420 of 2012. But until then, please contact any of us Stanley brothers directly through email. You can get us at gratefuljosh@hotmail.com. Now come on, Colorado. We need to take care of each other. Join the realm. That's realmofcaring.com. Thank you so much.
And we're back. You like how I just stretched that out?
And...
We should probably mention our other shows. Monday night, I was going to sit in on George's show. It's kind of just Monday with George at this point, I think, is what it's dubbed.
News and...
Yeah. I totally bailed on her. So right. I give her an honor apology for bailing on her show and leaving.
And a plug. So everyone listen to her show on Monday nights at 7 o'clock.
And Tuesday nights, Sex Pot, 8 to 10. Janie Cush and whoever else she... pulls in. It's usually pretty interesting. Wednesday night's IDAB. I got to produce last night.
Once a month, though, right now, right?
Yeah, they're once a month.
On Wednesday.
Yeah, but it's a fun time. Like
and then our show.
Well, yeah, there's our show, but we forgot THC.
Oh, yes, one more. Oh,
the Hemp Connoisseur Radio is 4 to 5 on Thursdays.
They have a very informational show.
Yeah, they lead up to our show.
Right. And Overgrow course, the Radio.
Yeah, what you're listening to. You know all about that one.
And all thanks to iCannabisRadio.com.
And I'm going to just throw it out there that I'm working on a friend on a science show, you know, based on cannabis science. So hopefully the beginning of the new year, hint, hint, if you're listening, that show will be up and going and be a welcome addition to our lineup here. So if anybody out there has a show idea that they want to plug to us or pitch to us, email me at stickman200210@gmail. Also, you know, you can always, there's always sponsorship opportunities at our show and different shows, and you can get me at the same email address about that as well. So our next guest, who Sam is dialing right now, is my buddy Thurlow Weed, and... you know, I don't look at any of us as competitors. He's got another radio show. He's got a little network going on, got a little TV happening. But what we're going to chat with him about is this little competition he's got going on. I'm a fan of edibles. You like edibles?
Please leave your message at night. See, every time we call our guests tonight, they're just getting their back right. So I think that, you know, it gives us a good time to banter, but
I think that edibles are really good for deep pain because, you know, it takes a while. It has to go through your stomach. It makes it a lot more potent, I feel, because I get way more medicated when I eat an edible.
Yeah, please leave your message for
Thurlow Weed.
Thurlow Weed.
We're gonna keep trying him because I just sent him a text. But yeah, I'm the same way. I mean, for me, edibles are a nighttime thing usually.
Please leave your message.
Yeah, definitely. It's definitely a nighttime thing for me too, and I have to make sure I have other food around because the scary thing about edibles is that, you know, if you have tasty, delicious, sweet edibles, you know, you can get a little carried away, and people don't realize. I know that. I've given a close family member of mine an edible because she had severe neurological pain. And I forgot to tell her to only eat half of the edible because it was strong. And so she ate the whole edible and she watched a movie and nothing happened. But an hour and a half, 2 hours later, she stands up to go to bed and she's like, oh, it's not working. Goes to walk down the hallway and starts to stumble because she ate the whole edible. So it's definitely, you know, you can definitely eat too much when you go into edibles. It's easier to gauge your dosage when you smoke or vaporize. You can, you know, take one hit or one vaporize, you know, vaporized hit.
One and vaporize?
Yeah.
See, is how that it like feels. A whole vaporizer? Do you eat the whole vape? I'm
just rambling on, but.
So yeah. What's happening, and I like to just blame the feds every time this shit happens. So Thurlow is another activist / cannabis talk show host. And apparently we're trying to get him on Skype and his phone's not even ringing. He just calls me on the cell phone and says, yo, the phone's not ringing. Mm-hmm. So I'm waiting on a text and we will get him in, hopefully, if we don't run out of time, with a home phone number, a landline. And we'll go from there. I'm sorry, continue. Just wanted to update that.
You know, I just think that, you know, we'll find out from Thurlow a little more about what he thinks. But you know, as people that are new to the cannabis industry and new to using cannabis for medicine, you know, it's good to educate yourself, you know, and what the different forms of ingestion can do for you. That some of them can be really strong and, you know, some things might not be good enough for you.
And I think the cool thing as we go on is the consistency that's getting there with edibles. You know, for the longest time, my biggest issue with edibles was the consistency. And now that that's there, you can find some edibles that you can use during the day without falling asleep and falling on your face. In the beginning, that was my problem when I first moved here. They weren't regulated as tightly, and people didn't test them as regularly. And you could tell, I mean, there were some times I'd get an edible that did absolutely nothing, and there were other times where I was in bed like,
right, because some people use trim and things like that, or, you know, the old school way people think you can just put herb right into an edible. You know, it tastes really disgusting, but, you know, well, that's how people used to do it. And now they're realizing you can extract out of the trim and just put it right into butter or oil.
Hello.
Have a lighter taste.
What up, Thurlow Weed?
Hey, what's going on, guys? The feds were trying to fuck shit up again, but they will not prevail. I'm telling you, I was listening in. And, yeah, I know what you mean. Sometimes that happens to me, and I'm telling you, they try to mess stuff up, but it's just not going to happen.
Oh, dude, you know they do. They got to get the memo that 64 passed by a large margin. We don't want him here. John Walsh, you know, I didn't even get to his statement in the news tonight, brother, but it's absurd. Just go away.
So, Thurlow, where are you located? Are you in Colorado?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Okay. I'm in Denver. I was actually on Stickman's show earlier this year. That was when I was on my 2.5-month cannabis education tour. I was out on the West Coast trying to let him educate people about cannabis and kind of just pull the whole community as a whole together nationwide. So Stickman doing what he does and me out there beating the streets and doing what I do, and hopefully this first worldwide cannabis cooking contest that I'm doing is really going to help bring the community together as a whole as well.
Did you say cannabis cooking contest?
Yeah, worldwide cannabis cooking contest. We do have contestants from United Kingdom and Canada that have entered. So This is a worldwide contest, so it's very unique. People can go ahead and enter noexcusesentertainment.com. What makes this very unique is the finale is being held here in Denver, February 16th at the Oriental Theater. Nobody has to cook to make it to the finale. You guys got to remember, we're looking for the next Medicated Chef for my 2013 Medicated Chef show for season one and a $5,000 grand prize. But what we want is we want people that are going to look good on video, not just cook good. So we want to get a lot of the video part done first. So you can go to noexcusesentertainment.com if you're over 21. It used to be you had to be a medical cannabis patient, but now that 64 passed, you just got to be over 21. Anywhere in the world, you can go to noexcusesentertainment.com, pay $25, send in your video of what you know about cannabis cooking, 2 to 5 minutes long, why you should be the next Medicated Chef. We're going to go ahead and upload all those videos online January 2nd. Also, if you do want to cook it first, we are having a preliminary round in Washington at Sunshine Organics Washington Farmers Market this Saturday, as well as at AJ Hashman's Meet and Greet this Sunday. So if you want to enter that, it's no cost. You actually can win your entrance there. You just bring in what you want to go ahead and have as your entry. We've got judges down there, myself, AJ Hashman, Eric Knutson from Keith Cola. I think Joel from Chronic Magazine is going to be out there, and then quite a few others. We're going to go ahead and do some judging. If you guys go ahead and make it in the finals there, the top two, you'll get to in the judging as well. The judging is going to run January 2nd to January 9th on YouTube, youtube.com/TheIBakeTV. The five videos with the most votes, those people will be competing live February 16th. Myself, Johnny Richter from the Cottonmouth Kings co-hosting, Steve Elliott from Toke of the Town's a guest judge, Russ Belville from the Russ Belville Show is a guest judge, Canopy Lee from Canopy E-Joints is a guest judge, Serena Haskins from Washington Organics, Sunshine Organics, Washington Farmers Market's a guest judge. I think we got Miss High Times 2011 as well. So I know you guys I needed to get this out quick because you guys got a time limit. So I think I kind of summed it up. If you guys got any questions for any parts I may have missed, definitely let me know.
So is this any type of cannabis food, or are you going to have different categories, or is it sweet foods?
Okay, so check this out. This is how we're doing it. We're going to know in January when the five finalists are. So Friday the 15th, live on my show, we are going to draw numbers for baskets, and in those baskets, they are going to find out then what is in those baskets. Then they've got 36 hours to decide, write the recipe, and then they'll be cooking for us live. We'll be testing live. It is a pro-cannabis facility, so if you're 21 and up, you know, you can get your tickets, 2013 Medicated Chef Contest, .eventbrite.com. The VIPs are $100, but you get special gift bags, if you know what I'm saying, and posters, and CDs, and shirts, and hats, just a whole bunch of different stuff. Regular general admission are 20 right now, but they will be 25 or 30 at the door.
So general admission, does that get people edibles?
Nope. That's going to get them in the door. What's going to get them edibles and tasting is the VIP and hanging out with the judges and hanging out with myself and getting to talk with the cooks and stuff, because you guys are going to be able to, you guys won't be judging, but you will be able to go ahead and test. The VIPs will be able to go ahead and test and check out what's been cooked.
So in other words, just one of the guests. In other VIPs. Words, butter up to Thurlow and any of the judges that are present.
Exactly. I mean, there's great ones coming from out of state. This is, I really wanted to do something, to be honest with you, this started out as a Colorado-only contest after doing the mini-state tour that I did. Those people in those states were saying, well, wait, you just visit us, and now you're doing a contest, and we can't even be invited. And I'm like, all right, so we can do a nationwide contest. But then I've got listeners on my show from Canada and all over the United Kingdom, and they were like, well, wait, can't we do this? And I'm like, well, really, you can't do it. But then once Amendment 64 passed, Governor Hickenlooper decided to sign it. Now I'm like, it's a free-for-all, so let's go ahead and do it worldwide, 21 and up, never been done before.
Cool, brother. Well,
sounds exciting.
We've talked off the air a little bit, and you know, we'll continue to follow the progress and do what we can to help out. As I premised our chat, you know, we both have radio shows, but we're all family. We're all working towards the same big picture.
Exactly.
And on that note,
the only way we'll do this and complete the goal that we want to complete is to do it together.
Exactly. I agree. On that note, before we do have to bid you adieu, if you will, I feel pretty confident in finally saying, though, that we're going to get you some shows from iCannabis Radio and be able to get those in rotation on No Excuses Entertainment really soon.
Very nice. Very nice. I'm excited about that. We've got a lot going on, and that would be a great addition and will help the community as a whole, because it'll get the word out from you guys and your shows to a lot broader people.
Absolutely, sir. And again, keep up the great work, and unity is key for everyone out there. Thurlow, before we let you go, you want to shout out your website one more time?
Yes, definitely. NoExcusesEntertainment.com. And don't forget, on iBake TV on Ustream, you can catch Wake and Bake with Thurlow Weed Monday through Friday, 8 a.m. till now 11 a.m., not just 10 a.m. We're doing a three-hour show 5 days a week, 11 a.m. Monday through Friday, Mountain Standard Time, so definitely check that out.
Extended.
And thank you very much to you, Stickman. And I am very sorry to say I did miss your co-host's name, but
Holly
thank
G.
you guys very much. Huh?
Holly G.
Holly G. Thank you very much, Holly G. Thank you very much, Stickman, iCannabis Radio. You guys do a great job. Keep it up.
Likewise, brother. Enjoy the rest of your night, and we will smoke a bowl soon.
Sounds good, my friend. I was doing that right now. You take care, buddy.
Right on.
Peace.
Later.
Yeah, I think, you know, we've talked about a lot tonight, and, you know, I've watched this week, for me anyway, there's been a lot of loss, a lot of turmoil. You know, it's just life. That's just life. And you know, there's a battle here, and I think just people from the outside looking in think that we have a perfect world here in Colorado, and you know, it's just all a free-for-all and happy stuff. And that's not it yet. We'll get there eventually. Sam's telling
me. Baby steps.
In this. Yeah, well, the key is unity. We have to stand together. We have to move forward united. What we talked about in a couple shows now is the fighting out in like Cali and different places. And guys, we've got a lot of work to do. What we do now and how we've moved forward with 64 is the most important part. So let's do what we can between now and the next time you get to hear our beautiful voices to make that happen.
Yes.
So thanks for listening. We love all you guys, and we'll talk to you next week. Peace.
The law offices of Etzen, Meaton, and Matz provide criminal defense, medical marijuana defense, and advice about setting up and running medical marijuana centers, optional premises cultivation operations, and infused product manufacturing businesses throughout Colorado. With offices in Denver and Aspen, we can offer assistance throughout the entire state of Colorado. Give us a call at 303-831-8188. That's 303-831-8188. Or visit us online at warrenetzen.com.
Hi, I'm Josh Stanley.
And I'm Jesse Stanley.
Two of the brothers here from National Geographic's American Weed, and we'd like to invite you to come into our dispensaries in Dispensary in Colorado Springs. Come in for the most pure organic strain selection in Colorado. It's all hand-grown by the Stanley brothers, especially for our patients. So come in and visit us at our two locations, East Platte and West Colorado. And remember,
always be kind to each other.
That Mad Hatter Smoke Shop has everything from space glass to butane and butane accessories, I tell you what. Located at 6901 West Colfax in Lakewood, and now at 2615 Walnut Street in Denver. Oh, God damn it, Reclaim, put your pants back.
Green Monster Glass, a full selection of glass and glass accessories, as well as all of your smoking needs. Stock your dispensary or smoke shop with reasonably priced glass from Green Monster Glass. Green Monster Glass is locally owned and operated. Find us on Facebook or call Daryl at 719-217-5380. That's 719-217-5380.